Hi, hello, good morning my students, welcome to the chemistry class. So in the last week we have discussed the inert electrodes. So means here electrodes are we are using to conduct electricity. By those electrodes, one undergo oxidation and another undergo reduction, there is a migration of ions and also electrons are transferring through the external wire so that we can have the electricity in the redox reaction. Means two electrodes are going to go, separate half reaction of oxidation, separate half reaction of reduction. Together we are going to call that as a redox reaction. Therefore, the redox reaction is going to conduct electricity. Because of that redox reaction, we are generating the electricity. So this is where we discussed in the last week. And also we observed that we need a salt bridge electrode, and electrode is dipped in an electrolyte. So these two are interconnected by the salt bridge that acts as a circuit, complete circuit. And electrodes are necessary, it's mandatory. Why? Because one electrode is undergo oxidation, other one is undergo reduction, and the surface of the electrode is necessary compulsorily to have the adsorption, it means dissolution or deposition. To continue this process, the electrode are necessary. If the solution is containing the HCl, HCl is nothing but H plus and Cl minus. If the metals, if zinc chloride is there, means we can use the zinc rod. Means if the copper is there, means we can use the copper rod. Copper rod is dipped in a copper solution, zinc rod is dipped in a zinc solution, aluminium is dipped in an aluminium solution. And here, if the compound is containing, if it is containing the HCl solution, hydrochloric acid is present, then we can't generate the hydrogen electrode. Because hydrogen is being a gas, we can't generate the rod by made up of hydrogen. For that reason, we need a separate electrode. Such electrodes are used for the gaseous compound, for example HCl. So here such kind of rods which are used to conduct the electricity, those are called as inert electrodes. In the last week we have discussed. So in the inert electrode, by using that inert electrode, the example is platinum. So platinum electrode is used as an inert electrode to conduct electricity. So I said in the previous video, the continuation we are studying today. Here we are going to use that inert electrode in today's concept. How and why, you will come to know that, because it's interrelated to each other. So if you have forgotten, please go through once again and understand this one and come to this video. Okay, let's begin. Today we will understand the measurement of electrode potential. Measurement of electrode potential, I have written shortly. So electrode potential is nothing but electrode, whichever we are using the cell, that is electrode. That electrode is nothing but, I said you in the last class also, in degree you are going to study that one. Here the electrode, it is in the form of this thing, that it is a transparent glass, just like your test tube. So it's containing some wires and some metallic liquid will be there. Here this is open and it is a wire, and this is, we are going to call as a cell, we are commonly called as cell. And it is, we are considering now as an electrode potential. Electrode, it is one of the electrode. We are going to keep this electrode in some of the solution. So using this electrode potential, we are going to calculate what is the transformation of current in this solution. How much ions are generating, we are going to calculate this one. So question is here, the heading is measurement of electrode potential. Measurement of electrode potential means, I am telling you, electrode is nothing but, it's a cell. We are going to call that as a cell. In the degree you are going to study this one. Cell, there are different kinds of cells are there. Those cells we are going to use to measure the potential of these ions. If the two ions are, it may be a single solution in a beaker, if we have mixed up water plus any of the salt, if those salts are going to conduct some electricity, how much current can be produced, generated, that can be measured by the sum of the electrode, those we are going to call as cell. But here we are not bothered about the cell, means which electrode we are using, we are not bothered, and we are not I am saying this is the application of electrode. So here this cell means this electrode we are going to use to check how much current is generating in this solution. But actually what the heading is, measurement of electrode potential means to conduct the generation of electrons or how much current is generating here, we have to use this electrode. Then to use this electrode, first we have to thoroughly understand what is the power of this electrode. What is the power of this electrode? So it means that whenever we are using some of the bulb, no doubt the bulb seems to be a same size, but it is having the different watts, 3 watt, 4 watt, 6 watt, 9 watt, 12 watt, means bulb size seems to be same, but the power is different. Similarly here, the cell seems to be a same, but the capacity of the cell is different, means the capacity of transformation of the current is different. So here we are going to measure, how to measure the electrode potential. Electrode potential means this cell, how much capacity it is having, that we are going to measure. How to measure this one means, look here, it is very simple. Think that it is one of the cell I am using, but I don't know actually what is the electrode potential of this one. I don't know, means it is, I have to calculate the electrode potential of this one. Then how I have to calculate means, I am going to use the another meter, and I am going to bring here another rod, that is electrode. These are connected to each other, and it may be connected to the battery, or it may be connected to some resonance, means resistor, external resistance, variable resistance, somewhere it is connected to each other. Look here we are using two electrodes. Can you see them? As we have observed in the radial cell, like that it is. So here, if we want to calculate the electrode potential of this cell, it means that I should use another electrode. These electrodes should be considered as a reference electrode. Reference electrode is nothing but, we have to familiar, initially before using this one, I should know the potential of this electrode. Potential of this electrode means to measure another different electrode potential, I am coupling. Coupling means I am combining. I am coupling this electrode potential with the another electrode. Those electrodes should have, it is considered as a zero potential. It means that it is not having any potential difference. It is zero, nil. How much current it is transferring? It is purely the current of another cell. It do not have any other separate storage or capacity or consumption. Nothing will be there. Means the potential, electrode potential of the electrode, those electrode potential is considered as a zero. Of some electrode. Those electrode is called as reference electrode, or it is called as standard electrode. So keep in your mind, it is not possible to consider any of the electrode as a zero electrode. Means the potential of, we can't consider without any taking one of the copper rod or a zinc rod or any other electrode, we can't consider that as a zero electrode potential. Why? Because we can't make them as a zero. It's not possible. For that reason, we are going to use another electrode. Those electrode is considered as not zero. Inbuilt, it is not having any potential difference. It is considered as zero. Such kind of electrode potential is called as standard electrode potential. Commonly we are going to call that as SHE, standard hydrogen electrode we are going to call. Means I say you, the standard electrode potential is nothing but what? The potential whose electrodes potential we know, that electrode is considered as standard electrode potential. Here the electrode potential of the some electrode potential whose value is considered as zero potential, such electrodes are called as SHE, that is called as standard hydrogen electrode. No doubt, don't get confused. Standard electrode potential means the values whose we are familiar,
means the electrode potential of the sum rods. If we are known, means then we are going to call that as SET, standard electrode potential. If the standard electrode potential value is zero, then we are going to call that as a standard hydrogen electrode. That is also called as normal hydrogen electrode. It means that here we are going to use the rod. Those rod are dipped in a SET sheet. It means hydrogen electrode we are going to use. Here the metal is used different one. Metal is used different. The metal is nothing but inert electrode we are going to use. What is this SET sheet? How we can able to measure this one? Means look here. I said if this rod is SET sheet, means this electrode is SET sheet. If one of the set is standard hydrogen electrode, standard hydrogen electrode means or normal hydrogen electrode, then the electrode potential of this SH is zero. It is SH is zero. And we are calculating the electrode potential of another unknown. So if we connected it in this manner, when the whatever the value potential difference we are measuring, it may be 1.5 or 2.3 or 0.45, how much voltage we may get, which one we are getting the value, the every value is the potential difference of this electrode potential. This electrode potential. Why? Because SH is having zero potential. It's not having any value. Which one the value we are observing in the measurement? Those all value purely it is the value of this unknown or the stranger electrode potential. So then how this SH is constructed in such a way that to have the zero potential difference? Let's look at the SH value. What is this SHE? How it is constructed? You are going to understand this one. So, let's start. Look here. Standard hydrogen electrode, that is shortly called as SHE. Normal hydrogen electrode, that is called as NHE. Here both are same. Don't get confused. SHE is also called as normal hydrogen electrode, NHE. So here we are going to discuss you the structure and the working condition and some reactions. These are important in this chapter about SHE. So let's start. SHE, don't spell it as a she. Why? Because this chapter is having most important concepts based on SHE means she. Let's start the structure of she. We will see how she is working, how she is have the application. Let's start her. Means let's start about the standard hydrogen electrode. Look here, this diagram is important. For that reason, I am drawing you by explaining. Think that here one beaker is there. One beaker is there. So in this beaker, we have considered the solution. That solution is nothing but HCl, hydrochloric acid. That HCl is having the concentration 1 molar. 1 molar concentration of HCl solution. This solution is containing H plus and Cl minus. H plus and Cl minus. This solution, to this hydrochloric solution, we are dipped by the one of the jacket rod, one of the rod. This rod is containing outermost, this is containing the glass tube, that is called as glass jacket. This is nothing but glass, it is made up of glass. So here this is glass, and inside the glass one more narrow glass is there, one more narrow small longitudinal glass is there. We are going to call this as a narrow glass. Narrow glass tube is narrow glass tube. Narrow glass tube. In this narrow glass tube we are having one wire. That wire is called as copper wire. That copper wire is present here. This copper wire is attached to a mercury. It is attached to a mercury. It is attached to a mercury. Means this is copper wire. This is copper wire, and it is attached to a mercury. Means Hg. That is nothing but mercury. I hope you can able to understand. It's a beaker. Beaker containing 1 molar of HCl. In that we are dipped a
electrode potential. Those potential is contained in the transparent glass, jacket glass as well as glass, and it is containing the narrow glass tube. That narrow glass tube is containing the wire, thin wire. That wire is made up of copper, therefore it is copper wire that is connected to the mercury. That mercury is connected to below a platinum foil. Platinum foil. This is platinum. Platinum. Actually, we are going to call it as a coil actually. Platinum coil. Look here, what is this platinum coil means? This mercury, it is bonded to the platinum. Actually, platinum. The platinum coil it is, but it is coated by another platinum. It is coated by another platinum. Inside one platinum coil is there. Apart from the platinum only, another platinum coated is there. Platinum coated is there. This is called as platinum coated. This platinum coated is, can you see here? Up to here the solution is there. Up to here the solution is there. We have dipped a electrode. This is in this way. Here, no doubt the electrode it is totally immersed in this one molar HCl. But this mercury means this platinum coil. This platinum coil is halfly immersed, means it not completely dipped, but it is immersed partially. Can you see here? Only half of this mercury, means half of this platinum coil is immersed in the one molar HCl in such a way that so there is a surface available for the deposition of HCl, for the deposition of HCl. Why? Because here in this solution hydrochloric acid, H plus and chlorine minus, the ions are added with the ions. H is in the form of positive first charge, chlorine it is in the form of minus, Cl minus. Here when we have connected this copper wire two separately, another electrode, another electrode. This is the arrangement of SHE. So SHE is nothing but what? Standard hydrogen electrode, or commonly we are going to call that as a NHE, normal hydrogen electrode. But commonly we are having the familiarity of the word SHE. So standard hydrogen electrode, it is a construction. It is contained in the a beaker which is containing one molar hydrochloric acid immersed by the electrode potential, that is called as SHE. This SHE is made up of a glass, that the glass containing a narrow glass tube. That narrow glass tube is containing the copper wire. That copper wire is connected to the mercury. That mercury is in contact with the platinum foil. Coil it is, that is coated by the another platinum, so that the surface, extra surface or larger surface should be available for the absorption of hydrogen ions. Why means? Here the hydrogen ions are present. Whenever we are connected into the another electrode, one here, the ions which is generated, that hydrogen ion has to be deposited on the electrode. Here electrode SHE means here ions are hydrochloric ions. We can't make the hydrogen electrode. Because of that, this hydrogen to undergo the adsorption, to undergo the deposition, one metal surface is required in a such a way that that metal should not be reacting with the hydrogen. Therefore, those metal surface or that electrode is considered as inert electrode. Means it is not having any reaction with the hydrogen ion. Therefore, hydrogen ions are undergo the this rod. No doubt it is under the copper mercury, but the deposition of hydrogen ions takes place through the surface of platinum. To the surface of platinum. Can you see here? Here there is a hydrogen ions are generated on the just above the surface level of HCl. In the above level, hydrogen ions are generating. Those hydrogen ions are under the deposition on the platinum wire, on the platinum coil it is, the surface of platinum. Can you see here, this is the SHE. SHE is nothing but, I say you, in the electrode potential we are going to use the inert electrode. Inert electrode is nothing but the one of the metal, that is platinum, we are going to use as the inert electrode. That inert electrode platinum do not undergo any reaction with the electrolyte, means HCl.
it is not attached to the HCl, but HCl need one electron to undergo the deposition. Therefore, we are using platinum. Can you see here? This is the construction of SHG. This is called as construction of SHG. So, sometime you may have a question like that. Explain the SHG means you have to draw the diagram and you have to write the explanation where it is constructed, how it is constructed, and working condition. You have to explain this one. I will explain in the working. This is construction. I hope you can able to explain it in a better way. Wait, first one more I forget. Here open is there above. From here we are sending the hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas which is having the pressure 1 bar. Which is having the pressure 1 bar means 1 bar of hydrogen gas is sent from the upside. I hope you can able to understand this one. This is the construction. So after the construction, what happens here? Working condition. Look here, it is very simple and interesting. Here SHG, it is a construction. This is a rod. This is an electrode. We are using this SHG to measure another electrode. To measure another electrode. In that simple understanding, if another electrode is there, if I want to calculate the electrode potential of this rod, then I am going to couple this together. So here this SHG is having zero electrode potential, is zero. How much the voltage is appearing is totally voltage of this another electrode. That is the heading. Actually, you are not going to get any question on measurement of electrode potential, but we are calculating that one in the next class. But look here, this is construction. Explanation you have to do here. SHG is made up of the glass junket and it's containing the narrow glass tube, which is containing the copper wire that is connected to the mercury. Mercury is connected to the platinum and platinum is coated by the platinum foil. Okay, so that is partially immersed in the 1 molar of HCl. This is about the construction, and hydrogen gas of 1 bar pressure is passed from the upside. This is about the construction. What about the working? So working here, look here, it is very important here. Working. Explain the working of SHG, they will ask you. For 3 marks, definitely this question will be there. Either construction or working or diagram. Along with the diagram, sometimes they may ask you the reactions also. So, be thorough to understand this one. Working, look here. SHG is considered as a standard hydrogen electrode. It is considered as a reference electrode here. When this is connected to the another electrode, here the hydrogen gas is undergoing, hydrogen gas is in the form of ions. They are going to form as a ions. That ions is going to deposit on the surface of platinum. On the surface of platinum, so that the hydrogens are initially, hydrogens initially is in the form of ions. After receiving one electron, it is going to form as a H, but we can't generate the hydrogen single, but we have to generate the hydrogen half of H. Are you getting this one? So initially hydrogen chloride, here the hydrogen in the form of ions, after receiving one electron, it's going to form as a neutral. That hydrogen is going to deposit on the surface of platinum. Hydrogen gas are formed as a bubbles. Those bubbles are just above the surface level of HCl. Those bubbles are undergo the deposition on the platinum foil. Those bubbles are neutralized by the upper pressure, that is 1 bar. That 1 bar pressure is maintained by the generation of, it is maintained by this electrode potential, this electrode. Look here, whenever the hydrogen is deposited on this electrode, whenever the hydrogen is deposited on this electrode, we are going to have this hydrogen ion. Yes, these ions are conducted as a half H2, means one hydrogen is generated. Here, the hydrogen deposited on the electrode potential of platinum, this platinum electrode itself is considered as a SHG. It is arbitrarily, means we are considered whenever it is at any temperature, at any concentration, the SHG is considered as always zero potential. It is considered as zero potential. Means it's not having any inbuilt current, is not generating. There is no potential is generating in this SHG. So whenever it is connected to the, whenever
whenever this SH is connected to the another electrode, in this is SH, it is connected to the another electrode, if it is connected here, we can measure the unknown electrode potential. We can measure the what is the electrode potential of this electrode by coupling with the SH. If SH is connected to the anode, please do remember the Daniel cell circuit. So anode is left side and cathode is right side. If anode it is considered, means SH, if it is at anode, then whatever the EMF electromotive force we are getting, it will be the positive or another electrode potential. Means if we want to calculate the electrode potential as a positive value, means the electrode potential will be appear as a positive EMF when we are connected SHE at anode. When SHE is at anode, at that condition the calculated EMF is always positive. If the SHE is connected at cathode, if it is connected as cathode, then the measured EMF is negative. Here SH is considered as reference electrode. Here we are going to consider SHE as an inert or reference electrode. Why? Because it may be an anode or it may be a cathode. Anywhere SHE, its electrode potential is always considered as zero. How much electrode potential we are observing in the wood metal, that is completely the EMF of another electrode. If we are obtaining the positive elements, it means SH is connected to the anode. If we want the negative EMF, means we have to connect the SH to the cathode. Means here we are connecting the SH, means we are using the SH to calculate the electrode potential of another cell by considering the SH as a zero potential. This is the working condition here. By this, one more concept is there, that is a cell representation of SHE. So I said you in the last class, in the conversion also, look here. Initially we are going to write the term. If we begin from the rod, if we begin from the cutting rod, can you see a copper wire? We are not writing the copper, but here electrode is nothing but we are going to call that platinum is the electrode, not the copper, because the hydrogen is going to deposit on the platinum surface, not on the copper surface. Whereas this mercury acts as a connection or breaking, making and breaking of what? The role of mercury here, due to this presence of mercury, we can make the connection of this SH to the another electrode to make the connection or break, means positive, means switch on and off, or connection or disconnection. The everything will be done by the mercury. It is done by the mercury. If the mercury is contact with the platinum, circuit will be generated. If mercury is not contact with the platinum, the connection will be breaked down. So it means the role of mercury is to make a connection or a break a connection of SH with another electrode, can be done by the mercury. So this is the role of mercury, and the transformation of electrons take place through the carbon, means through the copper wire, to another electrode. Look here, last one, the electrode potential. Here electrode, we are cell representation. Write the cell representation of SH. Cell representation of SH means the rod present is, electrode present is platinum. The platinum rod is undergo the surface. In that surface the hydrogen ions are deposited. A single bar, it undergo rod and ions, that is hydrogen gas is deposited. That hydrogen gas is present or generated by the hydrogen, that is H+. Can you see here in this cell representation, platinum it is being a solid, hydrogen being a gaseous compound. Here H+, it is aqueous form. Aqueous is nothing but what? One molar of hydrochloric acid. From this one molar of hydrochloric acid, we are generating the H+. That H+ ion, after receiving one electron, is going to form a deposition on the platinum surface. whereas platinum surface is a solid surface. You may write this S, gas, G and aqueous as H plus. Otherwise you can forget that, no problem. If you have written it, it's well and good. If you are not written it, no problem. But you have to mention this H plus is 1 molar of H plus. 1 molar of H plus must and should you have to write. 1 M is necessary because here hydrochloric acid is used as 1 molar concentration of HCl. Can you see here platinum rod which is undergo the surface for deposition of hydrogen? To this platinum surface, hydrogen gas is depositing. To this hydrogen gas are generated by the HCl, hydrochloric acid, which is having 1 molar, which is in the form of aqueous. This is called as cell representation of SHE. Write the cell representation of SHE means we have to write this one. Platinum rod, hydrogen gases from four deposits, and another rod which indicates the electrolyte. Electrode gases from four electrolyte. It is not connected to the any of the electrode. If it is connected to the another, then we have to continue this one by again continuing the salt bridge and everything. But it is simply the cell representation of SHE. Only the SHE if they ask means you have to write this one. Platinum hydrogen H plus. This bar is necessary, you are not supposed to draw the two line because it is, we are not having that salt bridge is not present in only SHE. So this is about the SHE. So from next onwards, in this concept, they will ask you draw the neat diagram of SHE and write the reaction taking place at SHE. So in the SHE, hydrogen ions are going to form as a hydrogen neutrons, and write the cell representation means this one, and explain the working of SHE means after drawing this diagram, we have to explain this one means along with the construction, where these ions are generating, how the ions are producing, and what is the role of mercury, which ions we are using. This is, you have to explain it one. So in the notes everything is there, but you have to remember how the question will arise. Explain the SHE, they may ask you, or diagram, cell representation and working, they may ask you. So continue the same concept today by calculation of means measurement of electrode potential. Copper and zinc we can calculate by using this SHE, means by connecting this SHE to the another rod, that is copper or zinc, we will calculate the copper and zinc electrode, because in your syllabus you are having these two. Let's see this one in the next class. Until, have a nice day.